Hello Hemo friends and welcome to this new video. After publishing my last sparring video, some people asked me some advices about how to improve their upward attacks, namely Sottani or Unterhau. So today I am going to share with you a little solo training trick to help you improve the way you land your Sottani while in the middle of an action. The critical part of this specific training is replicating at best the conditions in which you ideally want to be able to land your Sottano. For example, I am able to land it from my frontale parry, or from my feinted thrust, which means from posta longa, or also from posta di finestra. So I am going to show you the process starting from posta longa, which may represent a variety of different situations compared to the other positions. From posta longa, to land a decent upward cut, we need to recover our hands and bring them close to our body. To be able to do this properly, we are going to identify our ideal charging position, which represents the position in the space in which our sword has to pass to let our arms work out the cut properly. As you may already see in the 16th episode of the Longsword Beginner's Guide, link in the description by the way, the charging position of my reverse sottano, the left upward cut, is simply a variation of my posta frontale, more or less close to the body, depending from the situation. The charging position of my mandritto sottano, the right upward cut, is instead a variation of my porta di ferro. The ideal starting position of a mandritto sottano is coda longa, and for a couple of actions it is also the best charging position in the middle of an action, like for the one starting from posta di finestra, for example, which you may find in my video How to use the posta di spada, link in the description. But generally speaking, for the majority of the situations, the ideal motion passes from porta di ferro. The process, as you can see, is really straightforward. From the extended position, you recover the sword, and from there, you land the cut. The goal is simply to get into the mindset that to throw a proper sottano, you first of all need to move your hands backward. When you increase the speed, your action gets more fluid and tight, but if you train it properly, your arms will go back as much as needed to guarantee you a good mechanics. In terms of footwork, you may move forward, sideways or even backward. Try to experiment a little bit with it. And while doing so, remember that your feet position influences your torso rotation, which is critical to charge and land the sottano. The better advice here is try to feel if you are finding yourself comfortable with your shoulders during the execution. That is the best indicator that your body and foot position is correct. Very good people, a couple of advices to speed up your sottano. Remember that if you want more advices from me, you can join my Patreon community. Also, if you decide to go for the soldier tier or a higher one, you will also be able to join my Discord server, which will give you direct access to me, my sparring reviews, online coaching and more. Check the link to my Patreon page in the video description. Thanks for watching people, and as always, see you next time.